Jacob lived in a small village called Hillford. He had a happy attitude. His wife Stella was a simple-minded woman. Because of their good nature, everyone in the village was friendly with them. They had a daughter named Monica. Monica was a smart and studious girl. She always topped in her class. Therefore, her parents loved her very much. One day, Monica said to her mother,
"Mother, today I want chicken in my tiffin box. Can you give me?"
"Of course, dear, I can give you. But we don't take non-veg to school, understand? I will give you chicken in the evening."
"Actually, my friends love the chicken you cook. That's why I wanted it in tiffin."
"Okay, then you can invite them for a meal. Okay, now there is no problem, right?"
"Okay, mother, I will invite all my friends."
Next day, Monica went to school and told her friends that,
"Tomorrow, my mother is going to make chicken. All of you have to come to my home."
Ruth and Lisa agreed to come. And next day, both of them went to Monica's house. Ruth and Lisa ate the delicious chicken and said to Monica,
"Hey Monica, your mother is a great cook. The chicken was very tasty. I just loved it a lot."
"Yes, I also loved it a lot."
After finishing the meal, Ruth and Lisa left for their home. Monica was very happy because of this and she said to her mother,
"Mother, today my friends loved the chicken that you made."
"Really? But did you like it or not?"
"Yes, mother, I also liked it."
After that, Monica took her book and started studying. She finished her work. Stella also finished her house chores and waited for Jacob. After a while, Jacob came home and they ate their meal. Then they started getting ready for the next day. When Stella says to Jacob,
"Hey, did you know that girls loved the chicken? I loved hearing their praises."
"Hey, not just girls, but everyone likes the chicken you make."
"Huh, I know that you're just teasing me."
Then they went to sleep peacefully. Next day, they both got busy with their routine work. They left for their work. But after some days, due to lockdown, all the people in the village locked themselves in their houses. No one left their houses. Jacob lost his job in this lockdown. He was at home, which worried him about his future. Monica was also staying at home. Nobody was working.
"Hey, listen dear, in this lockdown, it is very difficult to earn living. Now what should we do?"
"But we can't do anything due to this lockdown. We have to manage with whatever we have somehow."
"But for how long we can do this? After a month, we have to go out to earn money for food."
"Yes, you are right. What can we do which will help us to earn money?"
Monica heard them talking and she said to both of them,
"Father, I have an idea. Everybody likes the chicken that mother makes because she cooks it on clay stove. Nowadays, nobody works so hard. So, we will cook chicken on clay stove and sell it to people. In this way, we will earn some money and people will get food at their homes."
"But how will we manage to do it?"
"With the help of this phone, Father, we will give our number to customers, create a WhatsApp group, and we will home deliver the food as per the order. And for payments, we will ask them to pay us by online transfer or even cash. Do you like my idea?"
"This is a great idea. But will it work?"
"Of course, it will work. There are many people who love to eat tasty food, understand?"
And then they started laughing loudly. Now it was decided that they will sell the chicken cooked on clay stove. Next day, Jacob messaged everyone about the chicken cooked on clay stove. On first day, he received 3 orders. Jacob brought the fresh chicken from market and Stella cooked it on clay stove. her chicken was so delicious that everyone loved it. And they were ready to deliver it home. Many people started giving them orders. And Jacob delivered the orders on time. Stella was also working very hard for this. And their hard work made it possible. One day,
"Hey Stella, what are you doing? Is the chicken ready?"
"Not yet. It will take a few minutes more. You will have to wait."
"Stella, you are so busy nowadays that you don't have spare time."
"That's true. But we have to work. And you don't have to worry about me. Monica also helps me."
"Yes, that's true."
Many days went in this way. Jacob was delivering tasty chicken to people at their homes. And the people were also happy with the tasty chicken.
"Hey, Stella, Christmas is coming."
"Yeah, it's just a few days for Christmas now."
"Here, take this money that I have saved. We can use it to celebrate."
"Hey, this year we won't waste money on gifts. Instead, we will use the money to buy some food for the people who lost their jobs due to lockdown. What do you think about it?"
"Dear Stella, what a great idea. I am very happy with this idea. Take this money, which I kept aside to buy new clothes. Use it to buy food too. We'll wear the clothes that we bought last year."
"Yes, we can do that."
"I am very happy, Stella. You are a very selfless person. And because of you, our daughter is also very kind."
All of them finished their dinner and went to sleep. And they celebrated Christmas happily. Because of their good heart and hard work, they managed to earn money even in lockdown. And they also managed to donate something to poor people. Now all of them are living a happy life. This story teaches us that where there is a will, there is a way. So we have to think positively and be caring.
A man named Thomas ran his poultry business in a village called Mancoos. He had lots of chickens and he took care of them. His mother and father lived with him. He kept plenty of chickens in his farm and handled them. He always told the chickens and always thought,
"How can I make my chickens fat?"
But his chickens weighed the same. He fed them with good food, but their weight never increased from 2 or 3 kgs. When Thomas went to sell them, he did something or the other to increase their weights. Sometime he puts chain in their neck so that their weight increased. Not only this, he tried some more tricks so that he could show added weight of his chickens while selling them. This way, he used to rob many people and the chicken shops. Sometimes he even had little fights with the shop owners. But he said his point in such a manner to people that they believed him and bought his chicken at higher price. Many days passed. Thomas was worried about increasing the weight of his chickens, but he did not find any way out. One day he was walking in the village. A man was selling Ayurvedic herbs in a shop there.
"Buy the medicine. This medicine has many qualities. It can make thin man fat and fat man thin. This medicine helps destroy many diseases. Come and take medicine and be healthy."
Thomas heard this and he thought,
"Why not ask medicine for my chickens from him? I will be very lucky if his medicine worked."
Saying this, Thomas goes to the man who was selling the herbs.
"Hey bro, are these herbs only for humans or for animals also?"
"Hey bro, you tell me your problem. I have solution to every problem."
"I want to increase the weight of my chickens. So give me some medicine for my chickens."
"Yes, there is a medicine, but it is costly."
"What is the price? Please tell me."
"It is for 5,000. It is very effective. Your chicken will grow faster with the medicine. Understood?"
"Okay, then give me the medicine for my chickens and here is 5,000 rupees.
The herb seller took rupees 5,000 from Thomas and gave him the medicine and he told him,
"Bro, feed your chicken with small amount. Otherwise, they will grow more than needed."
"Yes, I will remember."
Saying this, Thomas took the medicine and went from there. And after coming home, he added the medicine in a small amount in his chicken's food every day. After adding that, his chicken weighing 3 kgs became 4 kilos and they grew quite a lot in 1 week. Seeing this, Thomas was very happy and he sold his chicken at a very high cost. The chicken shop owners told Thomas,
"Hey bro, nowadays your chickens weigh quite high. What do you feed them, bro?"
"Nothing special, bro. They are eating the same stuff that they have daily."
"Okay, it's fine. I'm concerned with the chickens."
"Okay, please tell me how much will you give for this chicken?"
"I will give 1500 rupees for this."
"Okay, fine. Take this chicken and give me the money. I have lots of work to do."
Saying this, Thomas took the money and went away. And after going from there, he thought,
"If I feed the rest of the medicine to one chicken, how big it will become and people will rush to buy it."
Thinking this, he went home and he added a lot of medicine in one chicken's food and he fed it. The chicken ate that food and became very, very big in the morning. Seeing that chicken, Thomas himself got scared for a minute. But when again he looked at the chicken, he found that it was his chicken that he fed with the medicine the previous day. Seeing all this, Thomas thought,
"Wow, my chicken is such big one. Now I will sell it and get a lot of money."
Thinking this, he took the chicken to the chicken shop owner of the village and told him,
"Brother, take this big chicken. How much will you pay for it?"
"Hey Thomas bro, this chicken is so big. I will not buy this. If I will try to kill her, she will kill me. I don't need this."
"What's this, brother? You are afraid of a big chicken?"
Saying this, Thomas took the chicken and went from there. The second shop owner asked him,
"From where did you get such a big chicken?"
"This is specially for your shop. How much will you buy it for?"
"Oh bro, if I buy this chicken, it needs to be sold. No one will buy such a big chicken. I cannot buy this. If it was able to give me profit, I would have bought it."
"Okay, fine. I will leave."
Saying this, Thomas took his big chicken and visited every chicken shop. But no one bought it. So, he kept that chicken in his house for 2 days. That chicken had started eating a lot. It fed on the food of all the other chickens. And if it felt further hungry, it went into the village and ate whatever it found. People were afraid of such a big chicken and Thomas had to pay for their losses. 7 days passed in that way. Now,
"This chicken will kill me. And if it doesn't kill me, people will do that."
Saying this, Thomas took the chicken and went to the herb seller.
"How did this chicken grow so big? Did you feed it with large amount of medicine?"
"Yes, sir. Now I have to make it small so that I can sell it and get rid of it."
"That's a good idea. If you want this chicken to be small, you will have to give 5,000 rupees once more."
"Sure, you can have it, but please make this smaller."
Now, Thomas took medicine from the herb seller and the herb seller told him,
"Now, put this medicine in small amount to help the chicken lose weight and the chicken will become small like before."
"Yes, sir. I will do that."
Now, Thomas started adding that medicine to that chicken's food daily. The chicken became small as before. Now, Thomas understood that one should not be greedy. Thomas harmed himself because of the greed. This story teaches us that greed is bad. We should never become greedy in life.
In the small town of Rockwell, there lived a woman, Mary. She had a daughter, Tracy, and a son, Owen. Her son worked as a manager in a very big bank, and Mary was very proud about it. She took very good care of her son. Owen was very obedient and would always listen to his mother. Mary's daughter, Tracy, wanted to go study further and to work like her brother. But Mary believed that women shouldn't be working in office. So, as soon as Tracy finished her studies, Mary found a nice groom and got her daughter married in grand event. Then she started looking for a bride for her son. One day, Mary's brother Sam and his wife Lisa came to their house.
Welcome, brother. What is the reason behind this surprise visit?
I was in the neighborhood regarding my daughter's marriage, so I thought I should see how you are doing.
So nice of you, brother. Otherwise, you don't have time for anything else than your work. So what do you say?
It's a nice family, so I am thinking that I should get the elder daughter married as soon as possible. Then there are 3 more kids whose marriages I have to arrange for.
You have taken a right decision, brother. You should get Alice married very soon. She's completing her studies this year, right?
Yes, that's why I started searching for the groom.
Mary, if you don't mind, shall I ask you something?
Come on, Lisa. Why would I mind? You can say anything. Don't hesitate.
You know our Alice very well. You know that she's quiet, well-mannered. She always tops in her class. And she also knows how to do all the house chores. She respects elders too.
Of course, Lisa. I know that Alice is a very nice girl. I have seen her since childhood. She is my favorite niece. But please be clear about what are you trying to say.
Mary, I was thinking that instead of searching a groom from unknown family, it will be better if you accept Alice as your daughter-in-law. I heard you are also searching for a bride for Sam. If it happens, there will be no problem at all.
Mary thought to herself,
Alice is a really nice girl. She is well-cultured and beautiful too. But Lisa had all 4 girls. What if Alice marries my son and gives birth to only daughters? No way. My daughter-in-law should give birth to a son who will continue this family line. I can't accept this proposal after knowing all this. I should refuse now so I won't regret it further.
This is very nice idea, Lisa. But the problem is my husband don't like marriages arranged between the relatives. But you don't worry. I will help you find a nice boy for Alice.
Lisa knew very well that Mary is rejecting this proposal because she's scared that Alice will have only daughter just like her. Lisa and Sam talked for a while and then left for their home. After some days, they got Alice married to another boy. After a few months, Mary also found a nice girl, Diana. Owen and Diana got married. Diana was very beautiful and by profession, she was an engineer. She had modern beliefs. She would do all her duties and always obeyed her in-laws. One day, she got a call from a company.
Diana, who were you talking to? Your mom has called earlier. Then, with whom were you talking for so long?
Mother, I had applied for a job in a very big company. Now they are giving me a chance. They have called me for an interview tomorrow.
Diana, it's good that you are educated. But I won't like if my daughter-in-law work in a company. My son is earning very well. There is no need for you to find a job.
But mother...
I don't want to discuss it further. Go do your chores. I will talk to Owen in the evening when he will return home. Don't try to change my mind.
Diana quietly went into the kitchen and started doing her work. In the evening when Owen returned, Mary told him that Diana has applied for a job. She told him that she won't allow Diana to work and this is her final decision. Saying this, she left the room. Owen didn't believe in such things, but he always obeyed his mother. So he tried to convince his wife. Diana was sitting sadly in her room. He went to her.
What happened, Diana? Why do you look so sad?
You are asking as if you don't know anything. Now you tell me, am I not allowed to do job? It's not about just earning money. It is a chance to prove that I am capable of doing this job. That is why I want to work. Do you understand?
Diana, please calm down and listen to me. Look, I have no problem with your job, but my mother is orthodox. We can't change her way of thinking overnight. It's been just 2 months since we got married, and mother is also not feeling well these days. So let some days go. I will convince her after a few days, okay?
Diana agreed to this and she left the room smiling. Few months had passed and now Diana was pregnant. Mary started behaving nicely with Diana. She took very good care of her daughter-in-law. This made Diana very happy. After a few months, Diana gave birth to a beautiful daughter. But her mother-in-law did not like it. She told Diana that next time she wants a son.
What are you saying, mother? What does it matter if it's a girl or a boy? It's not Diana's fault.
You keep quiet and don't come between us. You don't understand anything. Go, do your work.
This made Diana very sad. She cried and went to her room. Mary started fighting with Diana every time. She would taunt Diana for giving birth to a daughter, and Diana had to do all the chores by herself. One day, Mary's sister-in-law Lisa came to her house and gave her sweets.
Mary, have some sweets. I have a very good news today, so I came here to celebrate it with you.
Mary ate a sweet and asked,
Okay, Lisa, but will you tell me what is the good news?
Alice gave birth to a son today. A son. I was in the neighborhood, so I thought I would share this good news with you. Now I have to leave. I'm in a hurry.
Lisa left the house. Mary was not happy with the news. In fact, she was very angry.
Lisa didn't come here to give me sweets. She came here to taunt me. I rejected her daughter, and now my daughter-in-law has a daughter while her daughter has a son. She wanted to rub it in my face. She wanted to prove me inferior and wrong. And all this happened because of this Diana.
Now her behavior got worse. She insulted her and made her do all the chores. Diana couldn't tolerate and left their home along with her daughter to stay with her parents. Owen managed to convince her to come back. 2-3 years passed like this. Now Diana was pregnant again.
Diana, if you give birth to daughter this time, then don't show me your face and don't come back here. I will get my son married to someone else.
Mother, I have tolerated all this for so many years, but not anymore. I don't care if this baby is a boy or a girl. Both are equal to me. From now on, if you try to torture me due to this, I will file a police complaint against you. Keep this in mind.
After hearing this reply, Mary started torturing her even more, even though she was pregnant. Mary didn't pay attention to her granddaughter also. She started behaving rudely with her too. Few days passed like this. On the day of delivery, Owen took Diana to the hospital, but Mary didn't go with them. Diana gave birth to a cute boy. Owen told this good news to his mother.
What? Is this true? I have grandson?
Yes, mother. It's a son.
Son, take me to the hospital right now. I want to see my grandson. I want to hold him.
Mary went to the hospital with Owen. She held her grandson in her arms.
Oh, my sweet child, my grandson. Your grandmother was waiting for you so long. After all this long wait, here you are finally.
Now I will show Lisa that I also have grandson. She was taunting me. Now I will not allow her to cross my door.
Mary was very happy now. Even she changed her attitude towards her daughter-in-law. After a few days, Mary's daughter Tracy was also pregnant and she came to stay with her mother. She took good care of Tracy. Diana also took care of Tracy. One day, Tracy said to Diana,
Diana, you are the best sister-in-law in the world. You take care of me so much. And please forgive me if you can. I knew that mother was torturing you. And even knowing this, I couldn't come forward to help you. But you still took care of everyone. We can't change my mother's nature.
Don't worry, Tracy. I'm just doing my duty. As a woman, I can't leave other women to herself in this situation. We have to understand this. First of all, we should do our duty as a woman. I know what you need in this situation. And hence, I'm giving it all to you. As there was no one for me who took care of me. What happened in my case, I won't let that happen to you.
Now it was time for Tracy's delivery, and she gave birth to a beautiful daughter. But her mother-in-law didn't like that, and she started insulting Tracy in front of Mary.
Look, Tracy, I wanted a grandson this time. Next time, I want grandson at any cost. We all know how much your mother tortured your sister-in-law. I am just telling you what I want. Keep that in mind.
Saying this, her mother-in-law left. Mary was listening to all this conversation. Now she was regretting about her behavior. Now she understood that she was a woman. Yet she failed to understand what her daughter-in-law is going through. And when this happened to her own daughter, she realized her mistake. She couldn't look into Diana's eyes due to shame. Now her thinking changed. She apologized to her daughter-in-law, and since that day she started treating boy and girl equally. She even gave permission to Diana to search a job. She started taking responsibilities at home, and all of them lived a happy life. This story teaches us that we should treat boys and girls equally.